Hi friends, today in this video I am going to discuss about the Quine Mc-Cluskey method, tabulation method. So the given problem is given as sum of minterms 4, 6, 9, 10, 11, 13 with don't care conditions 2, 12 and 15. The step 1 is to write each minterm in the binary form. So 4 is written as 0, 1, 0, 0, 4 bit binary form. We have taken 4 bit because the variables given as 4. That's why we have to represent each minterm as a 4 bit binary form. So 4 is written as 0, 1, 0, 0, 6 is written as 0, 1, 1, 0 and so on up to the given minterms. So don't care conditions also we have to represent in the form of 4 bit binary numbers. In step 2, what we have to do is you have to separate all the minterms as a group according to the number of ones present. First, we need to write all the minterms which contains zero number of ones. As you don't have any minterm with zero number of ones, we won't write that one. So here, next thing is you need to write the minterms which has one ones as a group. So if you see the minterms, given minterms, 4 is having 1, 1, 1 in the number and 2 is also having 1, 1. So you need to write these two minterms as a single group. And 6, 9, 10 and 12 containing 2 ones. So all the minterms you need to write as another group, 2 ones group. So next, 3 ones group minterms are 11 and 13. So you will write 11 and 13 in a third group. And 15 containing all 4 ones. So you will write 15 as a separate group. Now, each minterm of each group should be compared with the next minterm in the next group. So that is, 4 should be compared with 6. 4 should be compared with 9, 4 is compared with 10, 4 is compared with 12. So after comparing, you need to identify is there any 1 bit change is there or not. If you have the 1 bit change, you consider that comparison and keep a dash in the place where you have a 1 bit change. So 4 is compared with 6, so you have a 1 bit change at the C position, that is in 4 you have 0, 1, 0, 0, whereas 6, 0, 1, 1, 0. So there is a bit 1 bit change in the C place. So you consider that combination. So 4, 6 is 0, 1. Wherever 1 bit change is there, you keep a dash over there. Once a comparison is done and the combination is considered, you tick the terms. And then 4 and 9 is compared. And you don't find any 1 bit change there. There are more than 1 bit change. That is at D place 0 is changed to 1. And B place 1 is changed to 0. A place 0 is changed to 1. There is more than 1 bit change. So don't consider that combination. So similarly 4, 10 you have more than 1 bit change. And then 4, 12 you have only 1 bit change at the place of A. So you consider that combination 4, 12. And keep a dash at the A place. So 4 and 12 is compared and considered. So 12 is ticked and 4 is already ticked. So the same procedure is continued for 2 also. The 2 of this group is compared with 6, 9, 10, 12 and note the 1 bit changes. So that is 2 is compared with 6. There is a 1 bit change at the B place. So you keep a dash at the B place and consider that combination. Whenever combination is considered, you tick it. As 6 is already ticked, don't tick it. And then 2 should be compared with 9. There is no 1 bit change. There are more than 1 bit change. Don't consider that combination. 2 and 10, there is a 1 bit change. And at the place of A, so we have kept dash here. And 2, 12, there are more than 1 bit change. So don't consider that combination. In similar way, the second group of each minterm in the second group should be compared with the minterm in another group, in the next group, and find there are 1 bit changes or not. If there is 1 bit change, consider that group, consider that combination. So that is 6 should be compared with 11. There are more than one bit change, so don't consider that. 6 is compared with 13. There is more than two bits change, so don't consider that. So again, 9 should be compared with 11. There is a 1 bit change and we have return. So 9 and 11 should be ticked. So 9 is compared with 13. There is a 1 bit change. So we consider that combination. So 13 is ticked. And 10 should be compared with 11. There is a 1 bit change. So we consider that combination. So tick it. And then 10 and 13, you don't have a 1 bit change. More than 1 bit change is there. So don't consider that. Now 12 should be compared with 11. There are more than 2 bit changes, so don't consider that combination. And 12 is compared with 13. There is a 1 bit change at the position D, so we consider that combination and we have return here. Similarly, 11 and 13 should be compared with 15 and identify the 1 bit changes. So 11 and 15, there is a 1 bit change, we have return, so 15 is ticked. 13 and 15 should be compared and there is a 1 bit change at the position C. So consider that combination and tick it. Now the same procedure should be repeated for step 3 also. So each combination of this group should be compared with the other combination in another group and identify the 1 bit changes. So that is 4, 6 should be compared with each combination of this group. 4 and 12 should be compared with each combination of this group. So 4 and 6 should be compared with 9 and 11. There is no 1 bit change. There are more than 1 bit change. That is, even though the dash is matched, there are 3 bits are changed. 0 is changed to 1, 1 is changed to 0, 0 is changed to 1. So don't consider that combination. So first you need to match with the dashes. So next thing is 4 and 12 should be compared, that is you have a dash here at A, so you don't have any combination with dash in the A position, so you won't get any 1 bit changes. Similarly, 2, 6, you have B position dash, so you have only one combination in this group where B position is dash, that is 9, 13, but there are 3 bit changes, so don't consider that. And 2, 10, you have dash at A and you don't have any term in this group. So you won't find any combination with 1 bit difference. So now we'll come to the next group comparison. So that is 9 and 11 should be compared with 11 and 15. 9 and 11 should be compared with 13 and 15. So 9 and 11, if you compare with 11 and 15, there is no 1 bit change. And dash also not matched. So 9 and 11 should be compared with 13 and 15. So there is a match in the dash. And also you have a 1 bit change. So consider that combination. So 9, 11, 13, 15. I have written. 9, 11, 13, 15. So there is a 1 bit change at the position B. So dash dash 1. And 9 and 13 should be compared with 11 and 15. So dash matched and you also have 1 bit change at the position C. You consider that combination and made a tick. So you have a 1 bit change at the C position. So made a dash there. So other terms, that is 10, 11, 12, 13 having dashes at the D position, but you don't have any combination which has dash at the D position. So the comparison is over. Now you will come to the step 4. Here you have only one term, one combination. You don't have any other combination in any other group. The comparison should continue until you don't have any comparisons. So here you don't have any terms or combinations to compare and check for 1 bit changes. So we stop the comparisons here. Now we got the prime implicance as the unticked terms, that is 4, 6. Consider all the unticked terms 4, 6. You assume it as a P. 4, 12. You assume it as a Q. 2, 6 as R, 2, 10 as S, 10, 11 as T, 12, 13 as U, and you have here in this combination, we assume it as V. So all the unticked terms are called as prime implicants, and we labeled with some alphabets. So we have written the prime implicants here, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V and A, B, C, D with the zeros and ones. Now we are converting this to mean terms. So as you have 0 at A, you will write as A bar. As you have 1 at B, you will write B. Because you are going to write the Boolean expression in sum of mean terms. So in sum of mean terms, prime means 0, unprime means 1. So Q is B. You don't have any value here at A position, so you don't write that one. So B is having 1 there, so you write B. C is having 0 here, so C bar. D is having 0 here, D bar. Similarly, you will write all the mean terms. Now we need to find out the essential prime implicants. So draw the table with rows. As the prime implicants and columns as the mean terms given. Don't write the don't care conditions here. So you will write here only the mean terms. Don't write the don't care conditions. So now you made a cross in each row in the terms where how P is formed. For example, P is formed by the combination. P is formed by the combination 4, 6. So, you made a cross at 4, 6. Q is formed by the min terms 4, 12. So, made a cross at there. So, as you don't have 12 here, leave it. Similarly, R is formed by 2, 6. So, 2 is not there, 6 should be crossed. S is formed by 2, 10. So, 10 is crossed. 2 is not there, so leave it. And T is formed by 10, 11. You made a cross. U is formed by 12, 13. 12 is not there, so 13 is there, you made a cross. And V is formed by 9, 11 and 13. Okay. After crossing all the things, you have to identify the single cross columns. For example, in 13 you have 2 crosses, don't consider that column. 11 you have 2 crosses, don't consider. 10 you have 2 crosses, 9 you have single cross, so consider that. You mark it as a prime essential prime implicant. That is, identify single cross columns and the corresponding prime implicant is an essential min term. So next, 6 is having 2 crosses and 4 is having 2 crosses. So you don't have any further single cross columns. So next step is V is formed by the combinations 9, 11, 13 and 15. So tick the columns 9, 11 and 13. You don't have the 15. So now take the unticked columns. That is, you have 4, 6 as unticked columns. So now you need to choose the prime implicants which have the combinations 4, 6 and 10. If you see P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, you have 4 and 6 combination at P and 10 combination at 10 is there at S and T. So you consider P as one of the essential prime implicant. So 4 and 6 also be ticked. And now 10 alone is there. So 10 you have at 2, 10 and S as well as 10, 11 at T. So you can consider any one of the term. So I'm considering 10, 11 because 10 and 11 are given as the minterms. So 10, 11 I'm considering. So T also I'm making it as an essential prime implicant. So now 4 and 6 is covered in P term and 10 is covered in 2. So whatever the given minterms are all covered by the essential prime implicants P, T and V. So now my Boolean expression is F is equal to P plus T plus V. So that is F is equal to P is A bar B D bar plus T is A B bar C plus V is AD. So my final answer is A B D bar plus A B bar C plus AD. Thank you.